In this illustration, we'll analyze a rod inside a capillary tube. We are given that a glass rod of diameter 1.5 mm is inserted symmetrically into a glass capillary tube of inside diameter 2 mm. And now this arrangement is vertically oriented and brought in contact with the surface of water. Now it is asking to what height will water rise in capillary. We are given with the surface tension and angle of contact. So here, first to understand the situation clearly, we draw the figure. Here I'm drawing an enlarged view of a capillary. And inside this capillary, a glass rod is placed symmetrically so that there is an annular region left between the surface of glass rod and capillary walls. And when this is placed on the surface of water, due to surface tension, water will rise in it. In the annular region, say it rises to a height h, we are required to find this height h, which is to which the liquid is raised due to capillary action. Here we can calculate the force acting on the surface of glass rod as well as inner surface of capillary, which is pulling the liquid up. So if this force is F1 and this force is F2, which will also be acting on the whole surface, whole circumference, but we consider only once, as the whole circumference we'll consider here. So we can first calculate the total upward force of surface tension on water in annular region between rod and capillary is, here the force F1, which is acting due to the contact of water with the inner surface of cylinder, can be given as 2 pi R1 times T. If we consider R1 as the radius of rod and we consider R2 as the inner radius of capillary, then the force F2 can be given as 2 pi R2 T. Now, in this situation, here we can write, if water rises to a height h, then here we use the sum of forces F1 plus F2 must be balancing the weight of water which is raised in the annular region. So these forces we can write 2 pi T R1 plus R2 is equal to the mass of water which is raised in the annular region as volume multiplied by density. So this can be written as pi R2 square minus R1 square multiplied by H multiplied by rho times G. This is the mass I'm taking, as the surface area of water here is pi R2 square minus R1 square, and multiplying it with the capillary height gives us the volume of water which is raised up. So from here we are directly getting the capillary height H, and on simplifying this, we'll get a 2t divided by R2 minus R1 times rho g. If we substitute the values here, this 2 multiplied by surface tension is given as 0.075 divided by R2 minus R1. Here we are given that the diameter difference is 0.5 mm, so the radius difference is 0.25 into 10 to power minus 3 multiplied by density of water can be taken as 1000, and G we can consider as 10. So numerically, when you solve it, this will come out to be 0.15 by 2.5, that is 0.06 meter, or which is 6 centimeter, that is the result of this problem.